High quality development is seen as the first and foremost task in China's modernization bid, which means development that is innovative, coordinated, green, open, and inclusive. China aims to broaden its development with high standard opening up and deeper integration into the global industrial division and cooperation. But what does China's opening up bring to the world? In today's episode, we will shed some light on this. China is the world's second largest economy with over 1.4 billion people. Through greater opening up, China has embraced others with an ultra-large consumer market. China's total retail sales of consumer goods reached 44 trillion yuan in 2022, and imports of consumer goods reached more than 290 billion US dollars. Meanwhile, China adopted a foreign investment law, shortened negative list for foreign investment, and issued a series of measures to optimize the business environment, making the country a hotspot for foreign investment. In the first half of this year, 24,000 new foreign invested firms were established in China, marking a 35.7% increase year on year. Global investors can now invest in China's capital market through more channels more conveniently. Even during the COVID-19 pandemic, China held a string of international events to further open up its vast market to the world. This includes the China International Import Expo, the China International Consumer Products Expo, and China International Fair for Trade in Services. China has taken a host of actions to solidly promote high-level opening up, not only making good use of the global market and resources, but also promoting common development across the world. Today, we focus on three highlights. First, the Belt and Road Initiative. In a decade since its launch, China has signed more than 200 cooperation documents with more than 150 countries and more than 30 international organizations. As a result, more than 3,000 projects were generated with nearly 1 trillion US dollars in investment. Apart from developing countries, multinational companies from developed countries also discover fresh investment and cooperation potential in China. In recent years, many foreign companies have chosen China as their location for research and development to cater to the vast Chinese market's demands and serve a larger global market. For instance, Tesla. The car-making giant announced last year that it will build a new mega factory in Shanghai for manufacturing its energy storage product, Megapack. Second, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP. As the world's largest free trade pact, RCEP took effect last year and has served as a key support to regional trade through a tough year like 2022. Trade between China and other RCEP members in 2022 increased a 7.5% year-on-year to 12.95 trillion yuan. RCEP investment in China in actual use climbed 23.1% to 23.53 billion US dollars. Booming foreign trade has also been reported in other member countries. Thailand's trade with other RCEP members rose 7.11% year on year to 300 billion US dollars last year. In the first 4 months of 2023, Cambodia's export to RCEP countries surged 16% year on year. Third, free trade zones, or FTZs. China's pilot FTZs cover eastern, central, and western regions, and each one has strategic positioning and development goals. For instance, the Guangdong FTZ supports economic integration and transit with Hong Kong and Macau, while the Fujian FTZ focuses on promoting trade with Taiwan. Yunnan has long shared borders with Myanmar, Laos and Vietnam, making it a natural trading and access point between China and the ASEAN nations. The FTZs have become pace setters for China's high standard reform and opening up. To quote an expert, a more open China not only injects strong impetus into its development, but also delivers more opportunities for cooperation and win-win outcomes for the world.